Welcome to a video on solving one-step equations. This is the first of a series of videos on solving one-step equations. This video addresses the most basic type of one-step equations. Let's first talk about what a solution to an equation is. Any value for a variable that makes an equation true is called a solution to the equation. For example, x equals 8 is a solution to the equation x minus 3 equals 5, because if we replace or substitute 8 for x, we would have 8 minus 3 equals 5, which is true. To solve any equation means to find all of its solutions. The two principles we're going to use in this video to solve the one-step equations are the addition principle and the multiplication principle. The addition principle states that if we have a equals b, and then we add the same value to both sides of the equation will still be true. For example, we know that 5 is equal to 5, but now if we decide to add 2 to both sides, the equation will still be true, but now it'll be 7 equals 7. And there's a similar idea with multiplication. If we know that a is equal to b, and we multiply both sides of the equation by c, the equation will still be true. Again, if we start with 5 equals 5, and now decide to multiply both sides equation by the same value, let's say 2, the equation is still true. Now it would be 10 equals 10. So in general, the goal of solving an equation is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation, and we're going to use these principles to do just that. Let's go and take a look at our examples. Our first equation is x minus 8 equals 21. Again, our ultimate goal is to have x equal to some number on the right side. So if we look at the left side of the equation, we don't want x minus 8, we just want x. So we have to think to ourselves, what could we do to undo minus 8? Well, the opposite of minus 8 is plus 8. So if we add 8 on the left side, we can do that as long as we add 8 on the right side. Now if we simplify this, minus 8 plus 8, that would be 0. That's why we did that. So we're left with x on the left, which is what we wanted. And then on the right side, we have 21 plus 8. That would be 29. So x equals 29 is our solution. And again, we can check that. If we replace x with 29, we'd have 29 minus 8, which does equal 21. On this next problem, we have x plus 4 equals 11. Again, our goal is to have x on the left all by itself or isolated. So now if we think we have x plus 4, but we really just want x, how do we undo plus 4? Well, the opposite of plus 4 would be minus 4. And we can do that as long as we do the same on the right side. Now you may ask, well, we just said on the previous screen that you can only add a number to both sides, not subtract. Well, if we wanted to, we could add a negative, and that's the same as subtracting a positive. So we'll go ahead and leave it like this, though, because it's pretty obvious to see here that plus 4 and minus 4 will undo each other. So again, plus 4 minus 4, that would be 0. We're left with x on the left, and the right side would be 11 minus 4, which would give us 7. Now these next two problems, the variable is on the right side. It doesn't really matter what side the variable is on, as long as we isolate it. So for example, on number 3, since the variable is on the right side, so we're going to go ahead and set this up so that we'll have some number equal to x for our solution. So now we're looking at the side with the variable on it. This will be the right side. We don't want this minus 10 here. Well, the opposite of minus 10 would be plus 10. And again, we can do that as long as we do the same to the other side of the equation, and this time it would be the left side. So now if we simplify, and on the right side we have a minus 10 plus 10, that would be 0, and we're left with x, which is what we wanted. So 19 equals x is the same as x equals 19. So on number 4, again, the variable is on the right side. That's okay. Our final answer is going to be in the form of some number equals x. To isolate this x, we're going to have to do the opposite of plus 2. So we'll have to subtract 2 on both sides of the equation. So now on the left side, we have 17 minus 2. That's 15. On the right side, we have a plus 2 and a minus 2, that's going to be 0. and we're left with x isolated. So we have 15 equals x, or x equals 15. Let's do a couple more of these, and then we'll take a look at the multiplication principle. Again, notice the variable is on the left side, so our final answer is going to be in the form of x equals some number. We want to isolate the x, so we don't want this minus 5 here. The opposite of minus 5 is plus 5. We can do that as long as we do the same on the right side. Let's go ahead and see what we have. Minus 5 plus 5, that's 0. We're left with x on the left. On the right side, we have negative 16 plus 5. We have to watch our signs here. Negative 16 plus 5 would be negative 11. Here we have x plus 4 equals negative 17. The x is on the left, so we'll set it up like this. To isolate x, we want to undo or get rid of the plus 4, so we'll have to subtract 4 on the left and on the right. Plus 4 minus 4, that's 0, so we're left with x on the left. On the right, we have negative 17 minus 4. That's the same as negative 17 plus a negative 4, so that's going to give us negative 21. Now let's take a look at a few equations where we use the multiplication principle. Here we have 5x equals 75. Well, 5x means 5 times x. So to undo this multiplication, we're going to have to divide by 5. 5 divided by 5 will give us 1. 1 times x will be x. Of course, we have to do the same on the right side, so we'll divide 75 by 5. So this simplifies to 1x, just x, and 75 divided by 5 is going to be 15. On number 2, we have x divided by 4 equals 8. Remember, a fraction bar means division, so we want our answer to be in the form of x equals some number. Well, the opposite operation of dividing by 4 would be multiplying by 4. So we can multiply the left side by 4. I'm going to go ahead and put it as 4 over 1, as long as we do the same to the right side of the equation. Now here, these 4s simplify nicely. We're left with 1x, or just x. On the right side, we have 8 times 4, which is equal to 32. Now again, we talked about the multiplication principle, and here we did multiply, but on number 1 we actually divided. Remember that dividing by 5 is the same as multiplying by 1/5, so that principle still does apply. The main thing is, whatever we do to one side, we must also do to the other. On number 3, we have 2 equals 6. The variable is on the right side. Our answer will be in the form of x equals some number. In order to isolate the variable, this 6 is attached by multiplication, so the opposite of multiplying by 6 will be dividing by 6. Divide by 6 on the right, divide by 6 on the left. 6 over 6, that would be 1x, or just x. 2/6 is equivalent to 1/3. So we do have to remember, if we get a fraction, we should simplify it. I'm going to copy this problem again so I have a little more room. The variable is on the right side, so our answer will be in the form of some number equals x. This means x divided by negative 3. The opposite of division is multiplication, so we're going to multiply both sides by negative 3. But I'm going to put this negative 3 over 1 on the right side. Since this is in fraction form, we also need to multiply the left side by negative 3. So on the right side, we have negative 3 times negative 3, that's positive 9. And on the right side, the negative 3 here and negative 3 here simplifies to 1. So on the right side, we have x. So our solution is x equals 9. Here we have 2/3 y equals 16. Now this one's a little bit trickier. 2/3 y means 2/3 times y. And of course, the opposite of multiplication is division. So we could divide both sides by 2/3. Remember, when working with fractions, instead of dividing by a fraction, we usually multiply by their reciprocal. So instead of dividing by 2/3, we're going to multiply both sides by 3/2. Since this is in fraction form, I'm going to go ahead and put this over 1. Now, why would you multiply by the reciprocal? Because look, the 3 simplify out, the 2 simplify out. We're left with y on the left. And on the right side, this simplifies nicely as well. 2 and 16 have a common factor of 2, so this simplifies to a 1, this simplifies to an 8. The right side, we have 8 times 3, that's 24, over 1, or just 24. I hope you found this video helpful. In the next video, we'll take a look at solving more of these one-step equations with fractions involved.